Welcome back to ArtLinks course. In this lecture, we will revise the concept of the motion of the electron or any charged particle between the cathode and the anode. We take this before in lecture number 2. So in this lecture, we revise this concept and we'll derive the equations, we'll derive it before using another method based on the kinetic energy concept that is given to the electron because of the potential between these two electrodes, the cathode and the anode. Let's revise back the setup of this problem. We have here a cathode, negative cathode, and positive anode. And we have electron that is placed at the cathode at t equal to 0, with velocity equal to 0. The voltage between the anode and the cathode is Va, as distance is d. The cathode is placed at x equal to 0 and the anode is placed at x equal to d. The electric field is uniform, which means that the electric field at any point here is constant, equal to this potential Va over distance d. This is the first derivative to the equation of the motion of the electron, which based on the concept that this electric field between these two electrodes will exert a force on the electron. This electric field is equal to xi in the direction of minus x, in this direction from the positive to the negative. This will exert a force, electric force, equal to the charge, which is minus qe, multiplied by the electric field, xi in the direction of minus x. So this minus will go with this minus. This force now, as we see, it is in the direction of x, in this direction, opposite to the electric field. So it will move or push the electron in the direction of x and create acceleration in the direction of x. This acceleration is just the derivative of the velocity to the time. So if it's equal to m in the acceleration, which is the derivative of the velocity with time, equal to this term here, the charge multiplied by the xi, the electric field. And the electric field is just equal to Va over t, constant. So dv will equal to dt multiplied by this term over m, like this. Taking the integral of both sides, so Vx will equal to qVa over md multiplied by t plus some constant. At t equal to 0, the velocity is equal to 0. So if we substitute here, 0 equal to constant multiplied by 0 plus c, so c equal to 0. So this is the first equation we derive for the velocity of the electron in the direction of x. And the velocity is equal to dx by dt. So dx will equal to this term here multiplied by dt, integrating both sides. So x equal to this multiplied by t squared over 2 plus some constant. As usual, at t equal to 0, this will cancel and this will also cancel because it's equal to 0, c equal to 0 also. So this is the second equation we derive in lecture number 2, which relates the distance to the line. This equation is a function of v and t. This equation is a function of x and t squared. So we can cancel t, the time, from these two equations and get another equation that relates the velocity in the direction of x and the direction of x, the distance traveled by the electron x. In our second derivative, or derivation, we will derive these three equations but in opposite way. Here we started by the velocity as a function of time, then the distance as a function of time, then the velocity as a function of the distance. According to this derivation, we will make the same, get the same three equations, but we will start with this equation, then we will get this equation, then finally we will get the velocity equation. Okay, how can we do this? And what is the main idea behind this second derivative? derivation. The idea is that if you place some electron in a potential, this potential will give the electron kinetic energy. This potential here, Va, is changing linearly with the distance. I mean, the voltage here is equal to zero, and the voltage here is equal to Va. How about the voltage here, just in the middle, between the anode and the cathode? It's Va over 2. So, we can say that the potential as a function of x is equal to Va over d multiplied by the distance x. So at any x, if you want to know the potential at this point, just measure this distance and substitute here, you will get the potential. The potential at 0, both x equal to 0 here, we will get V of 0 equal to 0. The potential here, both here x equal to d, will cancel d, so V of d equal to Va. Here x equal to d over 2, so d will cancel d, and the potential V will equal to Va over 2. Okay. So the kinetic energy given to the electron using this potential is also a function of x. The kinetic energy here is 0, and the potential here is maximum equal to q Va. At any point here, between the cathode and the anode, the kinetic energy equal to QE V of x. The kinetic energy is equal to half the mass multiplied by the square of the velocity. So, from these two terms here, V of x is equal to Va over d multiplied by x, and this is the q. So from these two terms, we can say that V equal to the square root of 2q Va over md multiplied by the square root of x, which is the same equation we derived it in the first derivation that relates the velocity with distance x. Then V of x is equal to the derivative of x to the time, dx squared t, multiplied by dt and dividing by the square root of x. So this right hand side will be equal to dx over the square root of x. Integrating this will equal to 2 the square root of x. And integrating this square root by multiplied by dt will equal to the same square root multiplied by t, plus some constant. At t equal to 0, this will cancel. X equal to 0, this also will cancel, so z equal to 0. So the relation of the x to the time is just equal to qva over 2md multiplied by t squared, which is the same equation we derived here. This one, number 2. Finally, the velocity is just the derivative of x to the t. So we'll have the first derivative of this equation. T squared will be 2t. 2 will cancel 2, so v will be equal to qv over omd multiplied by t, which is the first equation we derive it here.